Today we are going to see about organization of tissue. In that we are going to see about difference between meristematic tissue and permanent tissue. The next we are going to see about complex tissue. A complex tissue is made up of more than one type of tissues. In this we are going to study xylem and phloem as an example for complex tissue.
Differences between meristematic tissue and permanent tissue. Meristematic tissue. Meristematic tissues have dense cytoplasm and vacuoles are absent. Permanent tissue. Usually, large central vacuole is present in living permanent cells. Meristematic tissues. Intercellular space is absent. In permanent tissue, intercellular space is present. In meristematic tissue, component cells are small, spherical or polygonal and undifferentiated. Permanent tissue. Component cells are large, differentiated with different shapes. In meristematic tissue, cell wall is thin and elastic. In permanent tissue, cell wall is thick. In meristematic tissue, nucleus is large and prominent. In permanent tissue, nucleus is less conspicuous. In meristematic tissue, cells grow and divide regularly. In permanent tissue, cells do not normally divide. In meristematic tissues, it provides mechanical support and elasticity to the plant body. Permanent tissues provide only mechanical support. Now, we are going to see about complex tissue. Complex tissues are made of more than one type of cells that work together as a unit. Complex tissue consists of parenchyma and sclerenchyma cells. So here the common examples are xylem and phloem. Now we are going to study about xylem. Xylem is a conductive tissue which conducts water, mineral nutrients in upward direction from the roots to the leaves. Here the movement of water is unidirectional, that is, it is moving from the root to stem, then stem to leaves, that is, it is moving only in one direction. Xylem composed of hollow, non-living cells, that is, it will have a continuous lumen. Lumen means it is a small opening seen in the center of the xylem. Tissues give mechanical support to the plant body because the cells have lignified walls. The water conducting function of xylem is one of the major distinguishing features of vascular plants. Water is the primary solvent for plant nutrients and metabolism and is essential for photosynthesis, turgor, and for transport of minerals, hormones, and other signaling molecules. Xylem is composed of xylem tracheids, xylem fibers, xylem vessels, and xylem parenchyma. Xylem tracheids. These are elongated or tube-like dead cells with hard, thick, and lignified walls. Their ends are tapering, blunt or chisel-like and devoid of protoplast. They have large lumen without any content. Their function is conducting of water and providing mechanical support to plant. Xylem fiber. Xylem fibers. These cells are elongated, lignified, and pointed at both end. Xylem fibers are dead cells. Xylem fibers provide mechanical support to the plant. Xylem vessels. These are long cylindrical tube-like structure with lignified walls and wide central lumen. These cells are dead as these do not have protoplast. They are arranged in longitudinal series in which the partitioned walls are perforated. Perforated means having small holes in them, and so the entire structure look like a water pipe. Their main function is to transport of water and also to provide mechanical strength. Xylem parenchyma. These are living and thin-walled cells. The main function of the xylem parenchyma is to store starch and fatty substance. Now we are going to see about phloem. Phloem are living cells. Cell walls are porous. Porous means sponge-like. They allow exchange of materials with the neighboring cells. Functions: it carries the nutrients from one part to the other part wherever it is necessary. The food is prepared by the leaf. From the leaf, it takes the food to the necessary place where it is needed, that is, throughout the plant. Phloem is a complex tissue and consists of the following elements: sieve elements, companion cells, phloem fibers, and phloem parenchyma. Sieve elements. The conducting elements of the phloem are collectively called as sieve elements. Sieve tubes are elongated, tube-like, slender cells placed end to end. The transverse walls at the end are perforated. Perforated means having small holes and are known as sieve plates. The main function of the sieve tube is translocation of food. Translocation means passing from one place to another, from leaves to the storage organ of the plants. Companion cells. These are elongated cells attached to the lateral wall of the sieve tubes. A companion cells may be equal in length to the accompanying sieve tube element, or the mother cell may be divided transversely from a series of companion cells. Phloem parenchyma. The phloem parenchyma are living cells which have cytoplasm and nucleus. Their function is to store food material. Phloem fibers. Sclerenchymatous cells associated with primary and secondary phloem are commonly called phloem fibers. These cells are elongated, lignified, and provide mechanical strength to the plant body. Adaptations of xylem tissue. Absence of cross wall maintains a continuous lumen. Lumen means a gap in between the center of the cell. Dead empty tube maintains the continuity of the lumen. Protoplasts disintegrate, allows water to move efficiently. They have lignified walls. Walls are rigid. Xylem will not collapse supports the plant. Functions of the phloem tissue. The sieve tubes transport manufactured food from the leaves to all parts of the plant. The companion cells probably control the activities of the sieve tubes. Now we are going to see the difference between xylem and phloem. In xylem, it transports water and mineral from the root to the apical part of the plant. In phloem, it transports food material from the leaves to the growing parts of the plant. Xylem consists of tracheid vessels, xylem fibers, and xylem parenchyma. Phloem consists of sieve tubes, sieve cells, companion cells, and phloem fibers, and phloem parenchyma. In xylem, the xylem parenchyma is only living cell. In phloem, sieve tubes, sieve cells, companion cells, and phloem parenchyma are living cells. In xylem, tracheid vessels, xylem fiber are dead tissues. In phloem, phloem fibers are dead tissues. In xylem gives mechanical strength to the plant. Phloem does not give mechanical strength to the plant. In xylem, conduction of water by xylem is unidirectional, that is, from the roots to the apical part of the plant, that is, in one direction. In phloem, the food material's conduction is bidirectional, that is, from bi means both the side. The food will be transported up and down, that is, from the leaves to the storage organ or growing parts, or from storage organs to the growing part of the plant. Here, the xylem is star-shaped. Phloem is not star-shaped. Xylem occupies the center of the vascular bundle. Phloem occupies an outer side of the vascular bundle. In xylem, tubular with hard-walled cells. In phloem, tubular with soft-walled cells.